And they're all related.
Please join me with the town.
Allegiance to the flag, the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening, welcome to the Board of Selectmen's meeting for February 13th. Public comment, is there anybody from the public that would like to speak at this time? Seeing none? Nope, okay. Announcements and community calendar.
I have nothing, Mr. Chairman.
It's winter, there's snow, there's ice. Please drive safely, slow down, take it easy, watch out for pedestrians.
Phil?
No, sir, nothing.
Just a big thanks to town employees that are doing a great job keeping the roads as good as they can. This wind is very tough.
And my little PSA will be adopt a fire hydrant. The house you save may be your own. So, all right, we have a consent agenda. We have the Fire EMS Warm Zone Equipment Grant for $6,000 acceptance. Fred, do you want to?
Mr. Chairman, there is a, and we're already awarded the grant. This is for a fire, let's see. I believe this equips two of our fire officers with the materials necessary to respond to emergency.
That's what he talked about last week. When
so yes, he did. Yeah. And the grant has already been approved.
So I need a motion to accept the grant. Motion by Regina, seconded by Jim. All those in favor? Unanimous. Approval of minutes for January 30th.
Make a motion to approve them.
Second.
All those in favor? Unanimous. First appointment is Chris Jacobs and Jen Hale, our DPW director and deputy DPW director. First of all, as you guys had a busy weekend, and your department has had a busy weekend, and
I don't know who didn't assign it.
I think they've done a pretty good job on the roads.
I did, Regina. Did
all things considered, I think.
The crew did an amazing job. They
absolutely.
Really did.
For that side.
Must be.
Just what I
passed that off. Somebody didn't sign the last one.
Thank you, Director.
Somebody missed that last one.
Did you change it?
No, I didn't change it. Change names, protect the innocent. Good evening, everyone. How are you?
Very good.
Just as a community note, the transfer station was closed today. We did not pick up any refuse. We'll be doing the Monday routes tomorrow. Tuesday routes Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday we do everything else. The transfer station is normally closed on Tuesday, but it will be open all day tomorrow for anyone that would like to bring their refuse to the transfer station. It's just something we have to do in light of the last 24 hours. And yes, a lot of the guys did end up working close to 30 hours, I would say, between the time they came in and the time they went out. I'm always very impressed with their abilities. And I know as I could drive a heavy truck for 30 hours straight. You know, there was about a two-hour break between 12 midnight and 2:30 this morning, but when it was raining. But other than that, it was go the whole time. So thanks to my guys, our guys. Your employees. Here tonight to give you a quarterly update as to what the Public Works Department has been up to, is our current projects and what we plan on, a little glimmer as to what we plan on doing in the first quarter of next year. Solid waste disposal for 2016 was only 38 tons over whatever we for what we collected in 2015, and recycling was only a 6-ton increase over 15. The recycling rate stayed the same at 30%. We did change operations slightly. While we don't technically receive tires. They do seem to find their way to us. Last year, we ended up getting rid of about 250 tires, and we started a program where we're actually going to place them in a container so that they're not a fire hazard and just haphazardly laying around the site. The other major operation that we do is wastewater treatment. They processed 848 million gallons in 16. That's about a 3.2% increase over 15, and 3,142 tons of sludge. That's a 4% increase over 15.
Decrease.
Same?
Decrease.
Oh, yeah, decrease. Yeah. Thank you.
Slightly less.
I can, the plant did it, also accepted 1,555,000 gallons of septic waste. That's waste that comes from mostly septic tanks, which is also a 6.7% decrease from 15. Current projects. Currently, we have underway a wastewater treatment plant facilities plan with Wright Pierce. It started back on November 30th. We're making steady progress on that. What that is they're looking at our current wastewater treatment plant operations, coming up with some recommendations for the future or recommendations for our current operations. We also have a new employee, James Hafey. James is a resident of Langdale Drive. He started the last week of December. He's already stepping up to the plate. He's currently managing all the trench permits that have gone out. He's also maintaining our GIS, our mapping system, and really took the initiative to apply for our household hazardous waste grant. The state does give away monies to do that. It's a kind of a weird cycle. He applied in January, and the money isn't given out till almost the end of the year for next year. So in 17 or in 16, we actually missed the cycle. That's why we didn't have any grant money for 17. Sewer and Drainage Division's been busy up on Muncie Drive clearing out a drainage area that's our responsibility, meaning that they're doing some brush removal. We did have a culvert collapse on Brad Street to start the year off on January 2nd. We had looked at the culvert probably three times in the last 2 years. It had no holes in it. But interestingly enough, it collapsed because of outside pressure, in other words, and outside corrosion. These pipes, just the soil contact alone, combined with the acidity of the rainwater, they're actually eroding from the outside of the pipe to the inside. To address this, and we've already signed contracts to do it, we're having the pipes cleaned and then and inspected, and then we're probably on all the, or majority of the drainage pipes around town, we're going to be proceeding with having a liner installed inside of them. It's basically a cloth impregnated with epoxy. Once it dries, it hardens. It's actually a solid pipe within a pipe. And that'll save us from having to dig them up and buy all new pipes. It'll cut down on a lot of disruptions. The Church Street Force Main. That's your bailiwick. Go ahead.
Oh, my favorite project. So as we've continued to move forward, the 100% plans have been delivered to the state, the bid documents. The state has given their approval to put them out to bid. Tomorrow they will be posted, so they will go to the town's website, go out to the contractors per our purchasing policy. An ad has been run in the Union Leader, an ad has been run in Seacoast Online for the bid documents for anybody who's interested in bidding the project. Those bids, I believe, are due back March 14th, 10th, excuse me, with a mandatory pre-bid meeting on February 28th. So that is moving right along. There may be an addendum here or there issued as we, you know, do some tweaking, but the 100% plans are done.
Mosquito control. We did end up in the last month of the year, the mosquito control group purchased one steel container. We purchased one steel container, and all this summer, while the mosquito traps are placed out in the marsh, we're going to take apart or take down the tent that's collapsing and situate those containers better. and in the future all the traps will end up going inside those containers. It's been another, that'll, for us, will eliminate one of the yard maintenance issues that we've had. The traps, just due to the getting them out of the weather, will make them last longer and they'll survive. January 18th, the EPA finally released their long-awaited, what they call their MS4 permit. If you remember, a couple weeks ago, I brought a document along. I think it was deliberative session. It's a 200-page document. It basically outlines how we're supposed to start managing stormwater. There's $50,000 in this year's budget that's specifically to address this line, and I know a number of times, and I've always felt bad about it, is, I budget committee would ask me, well, when you're going to get started on this, and I said, well, when they issue the permit, and I think it was for almost 2 years in a row, I said, well, I think it's coming out soon. Well, soon finally happened. It was actually predicted that it was going to come out in January like that, because it would be between the election and the swearing in of the new president. And when I don't know if it's done intentionally, but everybody's focus is basically on something else. So that's when it comes out. Why don't you talk about the New England Environment Show?
We went down, myself, Mike Dubey, Mike Carl, James, and Chris. We went down. We met folks from Wright Pierce down there. We did a presentation on the Church Street Force Main project while we were there. It was well attended, and we had a lot of people quite in awe of how quick we did get the project done. So it was nice to hear their feedback and their comments from our little project here in town. They had a lot of exhibitors, a lot of stuff that we use up at the wastewater treatment plant, a lot of insight on looking at some of our sewage pipes and drainage pipes and technologies that are out there. It's always a good learning experience. So needless to say, that was a long, fun-filled day.
The landfill inspection report was received January 24th. We have an outside consultant that prepares that for us. Their consultant's name is, initials are ATC. They're out of Manchester. I reviewed it. It was satisfactory. It was actually very complete, and it's been shipped off to the Solid Waste Bureau of DES. It's an annual requirement, something that we do. A couple weeks ago, we also met with Parr Corporation. They're doing the preliminary design on the Mill Pond Dam. We've asked for more information regarding basically the spillway, fish ladders, outlet channel. These are things that we felt needed to get resolved before we actually pick a type of dam that we would desire or we would agree to. It's also hoped that by getting some answers to these questions, we can further refine the cost, because right now we're at the limit. We are at the upper limit of what the voters allowed us or have appropriated for this particular project. Also working on the Drake Side Road railroad abutments and plan to regrade the road. We've had in September, I had a field survey conducted of that section of the road for design purposes. We're having someone, not under my contract, contractors interested in acquiring some or all of the stone. As a result, he's having his engineer design the actual regrading plan, subject to our approval. That's in process. I know for a fact that the contractor himself is in Florida this fine month, so that's probably why we're not seeing a lot of activity on that. Teresa's been writing up another bid for chipping and disposing of brush. That's due to be released out in March. And March 13th, you can do this part if you would. Yeah. March 13th is, of course, we'll be setting up for the voting. And then taking all that stuff down on the day after the election, or the evening of the election.
And then, as you know, we did complete the stabilization repairs to Bicentennial Wall. Was down there earlier today. It is doing what it needs to do, and it is protecting that wall as we move forward, and hopefully after the March vote with a new design for that area. Currently in the vehicle maintenance department, Joe Gallagher, our new foreman, has been doing a fantastic job. I probably spend a good portion of my morning every morning talking with him. He's gone through and from widgets to gadgets to brakes to lines to tires to belts to you name it. He's out there. He's price shopping it. He's getting us the best prices. He's making very valuable decisions as far as what we replace in shop. He's added some tools to the shop that has allowed us to do some of our own welding. One of our guys has recently just finished his class on welding. So a lot of stuff is getting done. With that said, we are in the process of getting ready to do all the police vehicle inspections. They are due in the month of March. So the crew is working to get that all established. In the last quarter, we spent about $46,600 of the budget to repair the vehicles. Unfortunately, fortunately, or we can at least say where it's all going to, the majority of it is going towards our collection trucks. We have had Unit 92, which is one of the collection trucks. The oil pan rusted through, had to be replaced. That truck's only 5 years old. We've been experiencing problems with the gas regulators. Each time we get one part of it cleaned, another part needs a new part, and that part needs a new part, and we're just finding that it really tells a story. You replace it on one, you think you're in the clear, and within a week's time, the next truck's in for the same parts. So I guess consistency is working, as you put it, across the fleet of collection trucks, but it is... it's timely, but we are getting it done. Unit 11, this is not one of our collection trucks, but we lost its brake lines. The brake lines had rusted through, so we needed to replace those. Unit 47, this is a fuel tank. Started developing a leak, so we had to put a new fuel tank in it. That's one of the larger repairs when you're talking $2,000, $3,000, you know, not just $150 belts here and there. Unit 16, this unit we've been having issues with. We've done repairs to in the past. This time it was for a new front differential. Again, one of the larger repairs over the $2,000 mark. We have received one of our new trucks from last year's warrant. I will say there's always those that would like to be driving that one. So there's definitely a request for it. It's come with its plow and all its bells and whistles. And it's worked well for us in this storm. We have not received our new six-wheelers yet. They are coming. We are hoping to make it through with the ones that we have. They were out there full force, and they were also in the garage getting repairs during the storm. So we are waiting.
Second quarter, what we're looking to get done is, of course, the MS4 permit. It's an in for covering last year. It's going to have to be done and submitted in the second quarter. Typically, Jen has handled that in the past, but I'm sure Jim Heavy's going to be brought in a lot on that. We also have to prepare a collection system. That's our sewer collection system maintenance report. EPA is looking for that. Of course, the highway department will be busy. I know I was chided recently on my prediction for snow, and part of it comes from that. The fact that my brain's always working 3 months ahead. In the fall, I'm thinking about snow removal, and during snow removal, I'm actually thinking about spring projects. So I was jaded last week when it hit 40 and thought, great, we've turned the corner. I guess I should keep those thoughts to myself. So, but we're going to be moving on to, thinking about getting the boardwalks out to the beaches, distributing the refuse containers. Some of you remember a couple of years ago, it was 80 degrees for 3 days in a row in April, and we were slammed. So that's why we were thinking almost one season ahead. Generator permits, Air Resources Division, because we have a number of generators, there's going to be an Air Resources permit that has to be filled out for that. I'm sure Toby's as the weather breaks, we'll be eagerly starting the catch basin cleaning. I've already talked to Fred about having a surplus auction in May. Some of my storage areas are full of bikes and surplus office equipment and things of that nature, and PD's agreed that we'll just focus in on a particular weekend in May and arrange that to get done. The household hazardous waste, we've already focused in on an early date in June for that, based upon we anticipate approval at town meeting. Sidewalk work, what's left over from last year, a continuation from the list, will be put out to bid, and we're also looking to get some road resurfacing out to bid as soon as the weather breaks. And then probably hold off in the major part of the, well, a second round of it later in the summer based upon this year's approval money. We still have some money left over from last year. I think we're also going to be very busy with the Church Street Force Main repair or relocation. My gut feeling is that the information for that particular project very well received. And I'm thinking a lot of people are going to be backing the project. So I'm looking forward to getting it done. And the same thing, Lafayette Road sewer repair. It's a critical project, and we'll definitely be looking to get that done. My plans were not to start that until after the Seafood Festival, so that I didn't have the Church Street Force Main and the Lafayette Road project going on at the same time. My hair's white, and I thought if I do both, there'll be no hair. And the other thing is that we're doing new this year is we'll actually be putting out a bid for installation of new trees. As you know, last year I cut down an excess of 40 dead ones and diseased ones. The request was made to use a portion of the tree maintenance budget, to actually install new trees. I reached out to an arborist, and he's recommended different types of trees in different locations, and that'll go out to bid. So that's what we're going to be up to, what we've been up to.
That's it, huh?
It's just some minor stuff.
I have a list of like 12 more things, but I left my notebook at the office.
Regina?
Yeah, you guys obviously have been very busy, and you're already thinking about the summer. And Chris, I hope you're right, that people understand how important the Church Street Force Main is. I think you are. I think they do. But so we're hoping to have bids on that, like actual figures March, from at least three,
right,
by March 10.
They sent us the list, and they sent us 7 contractors. We added 3 to it that we, Jennifer and I, have had good working relationships with. We're trying to keep with the town's
purchasing policy,
at least get it out to 10. We're hoping to get 3 or 4 of those contractors back. There's already interest in the project. Earlier today, the question came up, do I answer the question? Do I refer them to Wright Pierce? We've elected to refer all those questions to Wright Pierce. That way there's a single point of information that's coming out. They've been our engineers. Is when we're battling snow, to put on a different hat, it's not a good way to manage. So the interest is out there. I think it's the size project that's going to attract some really good firms.
It's definitely a unique project.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Definitely.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
Yep.
Yeah, thank you, guys. Good report. And you're busy, busy. And you're reactive plus being proactive, which is good. You know, that looking forward to what's happening or what can happen. I have just a couple of questions. Interesting. 3.2% decrease in the wastewater. Now, with the town increasing with developments and stuff, any reason for that? Do you know, or any reason you could think of?
Part of it is due to how dry it was during the summer, so I had less infiltration. Part of it is we're also discovering more and more cases of unchecked runoff coming into the pipes. One particular case up on Kings Highway, another down in the Beach District off of Browns Ave. So everybody's more attuned to it, has their eyes open, and so we're finding these things. And when we start to eliminate them, you're going to see, I don't think we're going to see a marked decrease in plant flow, but as the town grows, you're just, it's going to be kept in balance or kept in check. I have to really chase down infiltration.
And that's good to know, and that's a proactive thing, right, rather than a reactive
because
thing.
It'll save us money in the long run. Fred, is we've had many a discussions about how costly some of these improvements could be at the plant, because I have to, you have to engineer for the peak flow. As long as I can keep the infiltration down and keep the peak flow number from bouncing off the ceiling, it'll save the town some money.
Water conservation goes a long way, you know, just as the recycling numbers, you know, staying at a flat 30, the more you recycle, the less you're paying in trash removal.
We did notice through July, August, September, due to the drought, the flow in the plant where it used to bounce 2.4 to 4 million gallons a day barely broke 3 on a number of days. So there's something going.
And then I don't know if now's the time to talk about it or anything, or the town manager too, the appeal on the Church Street force main.
Well, I can tell you it was put together.
Okay.
Mark was busy. We worked with Attorney Moore to put it together. It's pretty factual based, but it also is, and I know there's some concern out there, when you're going for an administrative appeal, you have to grab at every straw, every issue you may think you want to bring up. It's like preserving your rights to argue about things. So when you read Attorney Moore's, the administrative order that he put together, with our help, it has a huge bundle of things that we can and should discuss with the state. If you read them, you'd say, well, if we're appealing this, why are we going after a new, there again, yeah, it's, we just wrapped them all up and said, here's, preserve our rights to argue about everything from the color of the paper to the, you know, whether it's single-sided or double-sided, it's all in the administrative order. The other thing is, the wheels of government turn slow, and they're gonna take probably 30 days to review the appeal. I can't stop the process. This department has to keep moving forward. So let that appeal process work its way out. But either way, as like someone said at the deliberative session, either way, it's a project that has to be done, whose time has come. So, that's all.
And you're at the mercy of the state. I mean, you've put it in.
Yes.
It's
going to move as fast as they move it, and there's nothing you can do to...
Right. At this point, it does. It lies within their hands, and it lies within, you know, your attorney, Mark Gerald, and it lies with their attorney. And I'm sure those people will be in the room when this is discussed.
Right. And the other thing is the MS4, 200 pages. That's
yeah,
pretty detailed.
It is very detailed, almost too detailed, but I suppose better enough information rather than not enough. But that's partially why we have the asset management system we've asked for, the software, because it will allow us to address the requirements of the permit. And secondly, why I hired Jim Hafey. And that's why Jim's already getting his GIS information up to speed so that we can address this permit.
And you just, so the public GIS, what that means?
Geographic Information System. What we've done is we have maps, we have stacks of paper all over the place. What it allows us to do is bring them all together so that I can pick a certain section of town and say, okay, how many bedrooms in that section of time? What's the anticipated waste load? It answers questions like that because it has both the plan data and the information data.
When you talk about this MS4 permit, a lot of people said, well, we're going to have to do testing. You know, it's taking that map and going, well, how many outfalls do we have? Where have we been? Where have we tested? What's upstream of that outfall? It provides us a map to do the work that we're going to have to do.
So in the last year or so, you guys have really done a lot to become more efficient down there and to add things in so that you are more...
Right. It's clear that, you know, we don't have the capability to add five people, four people, two people. So, yes, we have to work, and I typically say to the staff, I don't want you working just hard, I want you working smart. That's why, when you know, and it's the same way this report's detailed out to you. The past is the past, how much water we treated last year, but what's going on this quarter, what's going on next quarter, what's going on, you know, I have to plant trees today if I want them to look good 5 years from now. It's things like that, and you're right, you have to work smart. I can't work much harder, but I can work smarter.
Okay.
And that's it. Those are the tools to help us work smarter.
Thank you, and you're doing a good job. And I, as Regina said, I ditto that. But I hope people realize the importance and take a good look at the Church Street Force Main and the Lafayette and read the Warren articles and research it and know what they're doing when they go into that voting booth. Thank you.
Yes. Great report, great work. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Rick?
Yes. So it looks like the solid waste disposal, the refuge rate, is just increased a little over half of 1%.
Right.
So it doesn't appear that we have tons more refuge coming in either with the new buildings that are there.
Many of the new buildings, we are not, because we've held, you know, the policies and we put it in place to sort of stay consistent, a lot of the stuff that's come before plan review committee, so that's the stuff I'll speak of, they're not getting the trash removal services. It's the people.
I agree with that, you know, that we have been holding the certain position. But, I mean, a lot of people seem to be under the impression that there's tons more waste, and that just isn't the case. And it doesn't appear that the recycling rate has gone up more, although it should. We wish that it would, because that would even increase, you know. So I think that we're doing a good job keeping up with what we've been doing. Whether, you know, later on tonight we're going to be talking about if there are going to be any changes to our policy, which seems to have been working very well for the last 3 years. What about the tires? Why aren't people paying for those tires when you take them?
Well, our contract with Waste Management doesn't allow us to dispose tires with them. We really don't have a disposal contract with anyone for tires. So most of the tires are actually returned to people. Well, when you go to a tire warehouse, you pay a dollar, they take your four spares. They're the ones that recycle them. But what we do end up having is the ones that inadvertently fall off the back of a pickup truck. I mean, I was here 5 years, and it took us 5 years to accumulate 200 of them. So roughly 40 a year, or a tire a week, you know, would be. But it did get to, it wasn't a good way to manage them, I'll put it that way. So I just forced the issue, and we're managing them in a totally different manner so that they're not a fire hazard, they're not a bug trap, they don't generate mosquitoes. They're put away, stored in a roll-off container, and then we keep track of what's in the container, and then we'll haul it away once every so often when the container gets full to wherever we need to do it. The other thing was half the tires they had rims on them, or wheels on them, and they can't be recycled. We had to handle those differently. So the thing with the trash, there's two things that go on, and it really came to light this past year. If you recall, Labor Day weekend, July 4th weekend, Memorial Day weekend, that's when all those additional rental units, if you will, or condos or seasonal dwellings, that's when they really come to light, if you will. Light as in physically reside in them. Because what we encountered July 4th weekend and Labor Day was normally we have six trailers, three for trash, three for recycling. Twice it's occurred on those big weekends where we literally had to take a full recycling trailer, bring it out back exercise the piston and dump all the contents out on the ground so that we could fill it with waste. Because in the three-day weekend, we received over 400 tons of trash. How does that compare? This month, the whole month for January was 426. So in 1 3-day period, we received everything that we equal to what we were receiving in January. So it isn't so much the, when you look at the, when we talk about the town's capability to manage waste, there's two things, for the total year and the total tonnage, but there's also what is the maximum that we can actually put in the trailers that we have and haul. And right now, we're maxed out in two areas, collection, the, you know, three sidearm trucks and two rear packers. During the summer, they leave the yard at 5 a.m. and they don't come back till 2. So they're booked out for those 13 weeks. So I don't have enough trucks. I'm not saying manpower. I'm saying trucks. Physically, they're maxed out. Then at the transfer station, we're maxed out on trailers. I physically can't handle any more trash, especially just on those big weekends. During the week, okay, yeah, I can handle an extra 50 tons. It's as long as it's spread out during the week. But I can't on those big weekends. And that's when it's a real problem for the town.
Well, and that's just something that we have to learn to deal with because...
We do.
Yeah, it's a summer resort. Half the people in Hampton are gone to Florida and Mexico and everywhere else at this time of the year.
Fred gave me a list of other condos that, you know, he did some research. Using the it takes about 2 minutes per cart to pick up. We know this from a waste study that was conducted 2 years ago. We know what the average weight is per container. If this list is half true, and I just half true, I need a new truck at $295,000. I need a driver at $50,000 plus what, $25,000 to $30,000 in benefits a year. I'm not in touch with the benefits. Add another $25,000 in tipping fees, and add another $21,500 in hauling costs. So the allocation of money in the budget, that $250,000 or $250,000, it is not adequate to cover this. We're at a shortfall of a whole truck, a whole driver, and about $100,000 in tipping, mm-hmm. And transportation.
Well, it sounds like we're going to have to address that because the citizens of Hampton have voted, and you know, what was that last Warren article, Fred, that we to reaffirm our trash policy? Didn't something go to the voters?
It didn't. There was a Warren article to try to eliminate all commercial
and
trash.
All commercial.
Yeah. And that failed.
So it's just this is something that we're going to have to work with. We're going to have to work with our budget. I, for one, am not in favor of changing the policy. I've been here all this time. We've gone over it and over it. It's been refined. It's been made lower. And I'm, for one, am for leaving it the way that it is. And if we have to deal with something different according to our policies of budgeting, then we need to do that because people are happy with the way that it is for the most part. Mm-hmm. The wastewater decreasing, I think you're right when you mentioned that it has something to do with the fact that it's so dry because we saw a tremendous decrease in what goes into the wastewater treatment plant when they put all new pipes down at the beach. Yeah. And that's something that we have to look for. We have to start deciding, you know, which pipes are we going to replace because it's not just at the beach. There are all these trees that are uptown dry going through all these old clay pipes. Mm-hmm. Those are the ones that need to be replaced. And when they are, this amount probably will continue to decrease.
I think it will.
Yeah, so that's something, again, that's a top priority of what we have to look at. And I'm just going to mention this. I don't know anything about it, but I got two emails about it. And I'm not even sure how to pronounce it, but there must be a water reservoir that's out there at the Dakota Pipeline that they've just allowed them to put all kinds of pipes underneath it's Lake Ahu, or O-A-H-E.
Yeah,
I don't know how to pronounce it.
South Midwest, yeah.
Yeah, so that, is there a possibility that these, what the guidelines that we're following, maybe they're all going to be minimized according to what's happening in Washington now, when things like that, the Dakota Pipeline is building, you know, which is a huge, that lake is a huge drinking reservoir.
Well, the similarities to what they're doing out there with the oil pipeline is similar to what Bill could tell you, how Seabrook pushes their wastewater or their cooling water back out to the ocean. In other words, there's a huge vertical separation between, let's say, the harbor and this discharge line. Well, I believe the same thing would happen out west. A huge vertical.
400 feet.
Yeah. Yeah. Vertical separation between where that line is in the river, so that there's minimizes the risk of cross contamination.
Mm. Probably because it's mountainous and stuff like that, maybe. Well, it's interesting to see that, you know, are you expecting to see any changes in the way things are dealt with?
From a construction perspective, no, but I believe that from all the chatter that I'm seeing, that the ability to pay for it or basically reinvesting in America, everyone's realized that as part of the gross national product, that we're only about 3% reinvesting in the United States back in sewer, water, basically utilities. Europeans have traditionally been around 7%. They don't seem to have as many issues. But they're also, I think they were at 7% because they're dealing with a lot older infrastructure. So for years they've had to, you know, replace things. I think it's just becoming more and more aware here in the United States. And so the chatter is from the professionals out of Washington, the American Public Works Association and others, is that you're going to see, be they stimulus dollars, maybe more money back to the states for bridges, sewer, water, things of that nature.
Well, it sounds like you're on top of it. Thank you very much for your report.
Thank you.
Work in progress.
And thank all your folks down there for the excellent job they did this weekend.
Thank you.
We had our whole winter's worth of snow in one weekend, which is good.
Yeah.
Because we got it over with fast. But, right. You know, it's been a long weekend for them, and I know.
Well, the next thing we get ready for is melting, because it's steadily, the temperature's going up all week, 41 degrees on Sunday. So there's going to be, Toby's going to be pulling his hair out, running around, trying to clear catch bases. So that'll be the next effort.
He'll be happy to see that.
That's right,
doesn't have much hair.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Next one is Warren Kelly, 377 Ocean Boulevard, Seaside Community Living. Request for solid waste and recycling pickup.
Mr. Chairman, I'm going to recuse myself from this discussion since it directly affects me.
Okay.
Where I
live. Good evening. So, nice to be back.
No, he's recused himself from this, where he lives in a condo.
He's recusing himself?
Okay.
Well, that was a nice lead-in. On a side note, at 1 year's annual taxes, we buy the town a whole new truck to pick up rubbish. So I thought that was a nice lead-in. I do want to say a lot of the owners of the condominium could not make it tonight due to the storm, but they wanted me to reiterate, we did send a letter to the town. They all sent a letter stating that I am speaking, in fact, for the entire organization, okay? Anyway, tonight's issue is about denying taxpayers who own condominiums trash pickup, yet in reality, I honestly feel it's a much larger issue. If tonight's ruling against our request without a solid, definitive rationale, then what stops the board in the future from voting to make condominium owners pay for other services in the future? The debate tonight is not why condominium owners are being treated differently than other homeowners. but why by an ordinance? I love this community. I'm personally involved in the community. I only ask the board to consider our points and vote in favor if you feel we are justified, or state your position clearly, which justifies a vote against our arguments. This being done, hopefully we can all go home satisfied with how the turnout is. It was stated, reviewing all of the films, it was stated at the last selectman meeting by one selectman that they were in favor for this for years and could not garner support. I don't believe this issue is going to go away, and I believe this may possibly be the time to resolve this issue once and for all. And hopefully I can convince you of that, or we can. The modification sought is to approve public trash pickup by the town, provided that all barrels are to be placed on the public sidewalk 2 feet apart from each other in front of the condominium building located at 377 Ocean Boulevard, Hampton, which would require no town equipment to have to travel on any private ways and would also not require any special town equipment. No dumpsters involved, nothing. The basis for our request of a modification of these conditions is that as taxpayers, we pay the same rate, almost $250,000 annually, as all other property owners in the town of Hampton that do enjoy public trash pickup. Our justifications for this requested modification are as follows. Upon the review of all the minutes of the planning board meetings that 377 Ocean Boulevard was approved at, the applicant was under the understanding that private trash pickup was a town condition. No discussion on this subject ever took place at all, and I feel as the applicant, that I was led to believe that this was simply a town condition. Never was I presented with the facts that there was an option in regard to trash pickup. You all may review the films yourself. The Hampton ordinance, which currently states no trash pickup for condominiums, was passed in April of 2016, while 377 Ocean Boulevard condominiums were permitted in 2015. I'm under the understanding that an ordinance cannot be applied to a property permitted before the ordinance was voted on. The state of New Hampshire ruling 356-B5 clearly states that no condominiums shall be treated differently than any other properties under a different form of ownership by zoning or any land use ordinance. And I believe I emailed and sent the town all copies of the state ruling. 377 Ocean Boulevard has over 100 feet of sidewalk, 6 feet by 8 feet, which will more than meet the current Hampton Town Bylaw number 420-13.1 Section C, requiring the placing of the barrels 2 feet apart. Unlike other condominiums, travel on any private roadway, again, is not required at 377 Ocean Boulevard, and no additional equipment is required. The 377 Ocean Boulevard condominiums, again, require no special trash pickup and are of like conditions as other properties under a different form of ownership that are permitted to have trash pickup. The town, 377 Ocean Boulevard is a residential area. There's no business trash pickup. And currently, a new subdivision, I went to the tax bureau today, last week, and a subdivision of 26 houses paying an average of $5,000 in taxes per home not only qualifies for trash pickup of barrels, yet the town of Hampton maintains their roadway, their sidewalks, they school their children, and maintain all of the public utilities going to these homes. The owners of the condominiums at 377 Ocean Boulevard pay an average tax rate of $8,000, yet we maintain our own roadways, require no schooling for children, and maintain all of our on-site utilities. And 90% of the owners are seasonal, therefore, why should these condominiums not be granted the same public services as other property owners under a different type of ownership, as the state of New Hampshire's ruling 356-B5 declares? We feel that the 377 Ocean Boulevard condominiums are in fact being treated differently by a zoning ordinance than other properties, and we ask that this be rectified. It could be argued that condominium projects such as 377 are in fact a windfall in regard to tax revenue and certainly not an expense to the town. The owners of 377 Ocean Boulevard do not feel that the arguments presented by the town, such as this rule has always been in place, or that if we do it, we have to do it for all other condominiums, is a valid justification for denial of the services that we do in fact pay for. We respectfully are presenting our conditions, which are unique to our location, and we speak for no other condominium project within the town, and we ask that you do not combine us with other towns. We are a unique situation, and I have already outlined the reasons why we qualify for trash pickup. Please understand, we all agree with the Board of Selectmen that if in fact the Hampton Town trucks had to drive on non-public road to access our barrels, or if the town of Hampton had to pick up any special equipment for dumpsters or any such things, then we would not be eligible for public trash pickup and would accept it. Yet in regards to our location, this is not the case, and we do meet the same conditions as our fellow taxpayers that enjoy pickup every week. Lastly, I want to be clear, and I must stress, so to end the discussion, the owners of 377 Ocean Boulevard absolutely, definitively do not speak for any other condominium project, and we ask this board do not compare us to any other project and deny us because you feel that other projects would all of a sudden, who are under a totally different set of circumstances, cost the town more money. I think I've outlined in great detail and done research as to why we as town taxpayers qualify, and we certainly pay for trash pickup as others do. Thank you for your time. I appreciate it.
Regina, you want to start? Or?
I have questions for, I don't know if it's going to be the town manager or maybe Chris or Jen can help me out with some historical facts. When 377 Ocean Boulevard was approved at the planning board originally, what were the circumstances of that as far as trash pickup?
I'm going to let Chris speak on those before my PRC days.
Okay.
Well, it actually started long before 377 Ocean Boulevard. Project south side of the OB, I think 83 to 89 Ocean Boulevard. The question came up then with 24 units, could we pick up the carts? Two things came to light. The carts were kept in corrals out back, and trying to get the carts out to the side of the road would have proven to be problematic. It would have, if you all jammed up the side of the road, J and K Streets, I think, there wasn't much room. The other thing, question that came to mind is, did we really want Hampton Beach to look like Cart City? That's on a Monday morning route with all those carts. Plus, the other thing is, it wouldn't be just Monday morning. It would actually be several mornings because we make trips down there, well, 7 days a week. So it came up for 83 to 89. It came up for 275. OB, the same issues came up. One, because of the private property. Secondly, you know, accessing them. Secondly, where were the carts going to be stored? And this is the same issue that, for instance, I addressed with Bernie's this past summer. He's limited, it's either 27 or 29 carts, because that's what he can put on the side street. I think it's L Street. We literally measured the length of the pavement because the understanding was we didn't want those carts with the potential odor from them to be languishing out on Ocean Boulevard. The ordinance reads, you know, we start during the summer at 5 a.m. I don't know of many people that want to get up at 4:30 a.m. on their vacation to wheel their carts out. So a lot of people put the carts out the night before. I'm not sure from an aesthetics perspective, how favorable that would be, having all these carts out on the sidewalk, OB sidewalk, all night long for the collection the next day on multiple nights. So the condos aren't being signaled out because they're condos. They were being signaled out because, A, I don't think we wanted the carts on OB. B, that it had been decided two or three selectmen's years, I'm thinking backwards, about, you know, that we weren't covered insurance-wise for going on private properties with our refuse trucks. So there was those were a number of the factors that weighed into, so it just carried out that starting like 2 years ago, I think with 83-89, was, there's no carts. There's no collection for those residential units. There is still for the businesses, like in the lower level of 83 and 89, but none for the residential units.
Going isn't it a state law that they're not supposed to go on to private property to pick up trash? That's what we were always told, I believe. Isn't that right, Fred?
It's not a state law, but it is an insurance problem because we're not covered for going on to private property. If you do and you have an accident, you're immediately at fault.
So when the new policy was done in April? Asking this for you,
yeah,
Regina.
Okay.
When it was done the last time in 2016, the previous policy wasn't really very much different. It might have been slightly more units or whatever. That's when there was an abrupt amount that was put to 5.
Right.
What was it before? It really hasn't changed.
And that's what I was trying to get to.
The same policy's been forever.
The policy has been there way before April of 16.
It just was reaffirmed.
We reaffirmed that in April, and we changed it to 4 or 5 units from that point on because...
It's been a dance that we've been dancing around. We've had numerous public meetings, many, many, many public meetings. And this is, so, you know, nothing here tonight that's been discussed is any different than what we heard at the public meetings.
You came up with the 5 condo units based upon 24 Kings Highway. It was 5
apartments.
5 cottages, actually, I think it's spread, 5 units spread out in 3 buildings. And because it was always, they weren't condos, they were actually 3 individual owned structures. And then it was everybody, I guess, got together or somehow they did a condo conversion. So the question came up, so how do we handle condo conversions? And that's when the line was drawn at 5. As long as the policy reads also that they have adequate frontage out front to stage those carts. So if you had a 5 unit condo project that only had their 20-foot paved entrance in, there's no place to put the carts because they can't put them in front of other people's properties. I still don't pick those up. So it's really been a combination of the access, i.e. not being on private property with our town equipment for insurance purposes, and do you have sufficient space to put that number of carts out front? That's been the limit.
Right, may I ask Chris a question to clarify if he was there? At 377 Ocean Boulevard, the statements you just made, the reason was the statements you addressed were, number one, they were in a corral, which meant manpower. 377, you agree, has got 8 feet, has the frontage, 2 feet apart, we meet the criteria, and we're also extra wide sidewalk at 8 feet.
And one thing that you haven't brought up, and it makes yours project and all the other condos different from everybody else's,
right,
you're asking to stage carts and impede a state sidewalk,
right,
not a town sidewalk. Well,
right, but same as everybody else on Ocean Boulevard.
No, well...
Same as all the other...
We don't...
You're supposed to leave them on your own property.
Exactly, they're supposed to be on
their
own property.
You're supposed to have them on your own property. That's where
all of the other places, I've researched this, I was putting them on Ocean Boulevard.
Yeah, but that's the problem. We can't just be hiring a guard to go out and do it. They're supposed to be on people's own property. Okay. They're not supposed to be on the sidewalks.
Well,
not, but on 377 Ocean Boulevard.
Rusty, are you?
Go ahead.
I did just want to say one thing because it really goes to Chris's end, because I do the PRC reviews now, so I did not do it for your. But one of the things that we're always talking about when it comes to our department's comments is we're looking at the planning board's regulation. It's going to the planning board to look at the project, to look how it fits in. And under the planning board's jurisdiction, you have the safety, the welfare, the public health, all those things that you look at the project. When you're looking at condominiums of this type, you're looking at a much higher density. So we're not just talking about the carts, you know, over 100-foot frontage, 2 feet apart, but where are they getting stored on site? Where are they going to be left? Chris brought up the part about the aesthetics. So when we're looking at it at a planning board perspective, that's why it's part of the approval. We're saying that, okay, we agree with how this is all laid out safety-wise, layout-wise, from your parking spaces to your side setbacks to the grade of your driveway to all the different things, the drainage on a site. We look at it all cohesively and go, okay, so we're saying that this is all fine, and you understand that then you will have to deal with your own private trash pickup. They go together. I mean, that is why we say it like that now. So I think that that's a big part of when you're looking at the example you said of a roadway that went down, and it was individual homes, and you had the room for, you know, trash barrels, and because they're being brought in and out. And there's always going to be differences. I mean, not everything is going to be cut and dry, but I just thought it was important to hear that it's at the PRC level when we are saying as a condition, and it's coming out of my mouth as a comment, you know, we're saying, okay, this all works as long as you understand that we are not going to be doing trash pickup. You need to have a dumpster. It needs to be within a screened fence, or you need to be doing X, Y, and Z. It's not just a statement that's thrown out there.
Thank you.
Anything else?
I'm good, thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Rick?
Yeah, you know, Fred, is that those same five cottages that we're talking about, is that the same ones where now we're having the problem with the fence?
No, it's not
the same one? Oh, I was just curious about that. the thing is, we have a policy. It's been decided. It's not fair to anybody else to try to make it different. This has gone on and on and on. You don't realize how many public hearings that we had. And everybody said exactly what you're saying. And this determination was made, and this is the policy. I haven't heard anything that you've had to say that's any different.
Except, sir, you're not addressing the legal, number one, the legal aspect.
You've already addressed it. That's what you don't understand.
No, you haven't. Before last meeting, I watched the tape five times. The last meeting, you kept coming up with, we need special equipment. It's going to cost millions of dollars. You'll have to go on a private way. I've addressed these issues, okay. And I'm asking, what's the difference between us and another house?
Is anyone going to change the policy?
Did you, when you went for the planning board?
Yes.
Did you sign? Did you agree to the fact that you were going to do your own trash pickup?
As I said before, and I guess I agreed by not disagreeing, and I went back as instructed last time. I've had the planning board overturn that ruling, and now the planning board has voted to allow me, they've reversed that condition. Understand, when you go in front of a planning board, when I was permitting 377, number one, it was revoked because of the fire chief after it was 100% done. I then had to go, I went 2 years I did this planning, and I think we ended up with one of the prettiest places on the beach. I was very careful to make it right. There were so many things that you're looking at. Quite frankly, trash barrels was the last thing anyone looked at, especially when you're involved in a project of that size. I was led to believe this was it. As I stated, there was no discussion. And my other project, it's never come up. And I look at all of Ocean Boulevard, look at all those condos, all those houses.
I have the floor right now. I can't imagine that it wasn't dealt with at the planning board, because I was on the planning board at that time.
It makes no difference at this point.
I was on the planning
board,
and I tried to get it to be more so that you qualified at the other place, you know, the one that's right beside you. I fought the battle that you're fighting, but this board has already made a policy. It's not any different than any other.
Well, this is your chance to correct it.
No, it isn't, because we've already listened to other people. Why everyone else was turned down. Why are we turning them down and then going to change it for you? Today I went, when I was, I had to go to an eye doctor, the guy was making small talk. He said, you know, I mentioned I was a selectman. He says, he says, I live in a condo, and he was the same exact argument, and he's from Old Orchard Beach. People just do not pick up condos.
That's an incorrect
story. Well,
first of all, you asked me to go.
I didn't ask you to, right, because I told you were wasting your time.
All right, then I wasted my time and money doing the right thing.
Choice.
I had my plan changed. I spent the money with legal counsel, went before the planning board. The planning board voted in favor of our condo association. I did the right thing. I am back here. I did the right thing again. I got legal opinions.
Does this have anything to do with our
policy? It does, because you keep talking about all the other condos. I've asked you respectfully to please talk about our condo.
You don't fit within it.
They don't meet the same criteria we meet.
You're wrong.
Well,
we've heard there's other with condos that are down at up at Place Cove, the ones that are there, those people were denied. They used to get their stuff picked up. Theirs was stopped, I believe. So, you know,
I'm not here to fight, but you have a town.
You're not here to fight, but you're not here to follow the policy. There is a policy. I was on your side, but this board made a policy, and I don't see anyone wanting to change it.
The town voters, the people who voted you all in, also a town meeting voted that if you have frontage to put your barrels 2 feet apart, then you are entitled to town pickup.
For condos.
It doesn't say houses either, and it certainly doesn't.
I don't really know that.
Wait a minute,
Fred. Can you address?
It doesn't say businesses either.
Address his issues.
The complaint is that we're violating the Condominium Act under the statute. Is that correct?
Well, that's one complaint. I'm also saying you're violating the town ordinance.
Well, let's do one of those.
Okay, the town. You can go either one.
The complaint is that we're violating the statutes dealing with condominiums. Is that correct?
No.
That's one of your complaints?
It's not a complaint. Please don't call it a complaint. We're here as taxpayers saying we are paying our taxes and we deserve the same benefits as the next taxpayer. It is not a complaint. I'm not here complaining.
You just read a long dissertation on the fact that the condominium statutes of this state forbid us to do what we're doing.
That was one paragraph of my presentation.
Okay. That's part of your presentation?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, the condominium statutes of the state are found in the 400 series or 400 series of RSAs. The subdivision requirements for this state for condominiums in this particular town are found in Title 46, which starts at Chapter 670 and goes through 677. The statutes dealing with solid waste are RSA 149M. Those statutes are very specific. And they give the power to determine whether trash will be picked up or not to this board by state law. And they've exercised a position that, in fact, they are not going to pick up condominiums unless they are 5 units or less. The town doesn't legally have to pick up trash at all. If you go to 149M, what it says is, the town is required to have a contractual obligation with some place for you to take the trash. We have that. And that contractual obligation by the town is at Turnkey Landfill in Rochester. We pick it up at our transfer station and we ask people to come there to, in fact, dispose of their trash there. There is no way, unless this board decides to change their position, that in fact it has any effect on your property other than it's in compliance with the state law.
How do you justify the taxes?
I don't have to justify anything.
Well, thank you. You also don't have to answer to me.
Well, no, because, you know, the taxes are assessed under a state statute.
And we
would... They're assessed because a building has a certain worth.
Okay.
They're assessed on what the sale of the building is and the units in the building are sold for. That's the state law in this state.
And you don't feel it's selective benefits by saying that these residents who live and pay taxes in this community, in fact, half of them only live here half a year, are denied the same town benefits as somebody who buys a home right next door to us on the same street.
The state law allows for that in this state.
We're talking about the town of Hampton, board of selectmen.
Yes, because we have people that lived in other condos for 30, 40 years that don't get their trash picked up.
We've already talked about this over and over again. I see nothing here that wants to make the board change. I was on your side. This other board decided it's not going to happen. What's going to happen? Is anyone here going to make a motion to change the policy?
Well, do you hear the public at all or no?
No.
Or you don't even hear the public?
We don't hear the public on things like this. This isn't a public hearing, is it, Rusty?
No, it's not a public hearing. You came to talk.
That's why she's not allowed to talk. You're the one that's supposed to be talking for them.
I didn't. I feel my, and as my presentation, I requested what I feel to be a strong, all I'm asking for is a rational argument.
We told you it's already been discussed.
Your answer continues to be it's the way it's been.
And, you know, and I've dealt with...
Well, one of the residents have gotten pictures of condominiums that have trash barrels all up and down the road, and maybe you could answer for those then, because your statement was just that we've had condominiums for 30 years that don't, and I didn't even see these pictures, but...
I guess you can't.
So... I see
it's not likely to change unless we bring everybody in, and I just don't see it happening because we've already done this over and over again. It's been done more at least three times that I know of. So how can we change it just for you? You're putting us in a position that's not going to happen.
Well, no, I'm changing it for 377 that I'm arguing meets the qualifications, not just for me.
No, I think if it changes, you probably won't get picked up at 375 or whatever it is either, because if it changes, it will be probably more restrictive is what I see happening.
So,
you know, that's the unfortunate part. That's the part I'm fighting for.
I hate
to see it get restricted even more than it is, and that's where I think it's going.
It's very difficult. What they're saying is it's very difficult for you to argue that 377 should be picked up and nobody else should be picked up.
I didn't say that. No, I met the requirements of being putting them on the street. We're not going. I've read all the requirements. I'm not going to reiterate them.
What they're telling you is you don't meet the requirements. You don't meet the requirements established by the board. You have more than 5 units.
That was done in April.
No. They increased it from 0 to 5.
Right.
Okay. There are condominiums in this town that have been grandfathered for 50 or 60 years as individual buildings, and were allowed to be picked up when they were converted from single-family residences to multi-family residences under condominium. Those are the only ones that we pick up.
So your only argument is if you own a condominium, you don't get trash pickup. You have no rationale there except that if you're a condominium, you don't get it because your rationale is not making sense.
My suggestion to you, okay, is the same suggestion I make to anyone in this position or any other position dealing with the town. If you object to the policy formulated by the board, you have the right to petition the town meeting to have all condominiums. You can't discriminate. It's going to have to be, because it's going to be a town law. Okay?
Let me finish.
Okay? It's going to be a town law. It's not going to be an ordinance or a direction by the board under the statute. It's going to be a law. It's going to be applied equally to everybody. So you're going to have to pick them all up. My suggestion is if you want to do that, then you take your argument to town meeting with a warrant article with the appropriation to buy all the equipment, hire all the employees.
I have no desire to do that, so don't even go there.
That's the only way it can change.
I don't think that there...
We were told you that
in
before.
I'm still not getting an answer. In my opinion... This is wrong. What this board is voting
matter.
On.
It
does matter. My opinion matters to me.
Well, if you
want
to change it, you have to do what Fred just told you, and that's what I told you also.
Someone has to go with a warrant article. It's too late to do it now this year.
I want to be clear before I leave. Your only answer why not is because it's a condominium.
No, it's because.
It's the policy.
Part of your requirements when you went to the planning board.
Oh, that's been reversed, so that's off the table.
No, that has not been reversed.
It has been reversed.
No. If you read the minutes of the planning board, it's only reversed if this board votes to reverse it. Otherwise, their determination is completely void and off the record. You ought to state that the way it is in their minutes, because that's the way it is in their minutes.
Excuse me. If this board okays it, then I'm fine. The planning
board. That is correct. But if they do not okay it, the planning board's vote is null and void.
If I go back to it's only because there's a policy stating no condominiums.
No, you can't twist the words.
I'm asking for...
You said the planning board had changed it, so therefore this board should change it, okay?
No, I said if this changed, as long as this board accepts it, the planning board has...
No, you didn't say that. You said it after I said it.
Because you clarified
it. Stop.
This happens to be your profession. This is not my profession.
Mincing words. You went to the planning board. You asked them if they would rescind their prior vote and change the options.
And I got a vote, yes.
Okay.
And
they voted yes, provided the Board of Selectmen votes it. Otherwise, their vote is null and void.
We all understand that. That's why I'm back here. That's
not going to happen. That's what we tried to tell you. You were told before, and I explained it to other people, that you have to do a Warren article. That's the only way.
You know, it's funny. I happen to believe in the democratic system of government. And I believe this
is
the greatest system of government. Town government is the greatest system of government.
So
I have the right to come here and argue with you.
You wasted your time. You could have done the Warren article for this year, but you didn't. And now you have to wait till next year.
Do we have anybody who wants to change this article, this policy? I see none.
That was pretty obvious. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Town manager's report.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, this is a final reminder. The town clerk's office will be closed from Friday, February 17th until Tuesday, February 21st. The state is changing over their programming and computer systems, and the result is we're not able to enter any data or material through the systems, so her office is going to be closed for that period of time. The State Department of Environmental Services Wetlands Division has issued its approval for the Route 101 sewer line construction if the article for its construction passes the town meeting on March 14th. For those of you, the next few items here are going to be with people who must do filings at the beginning of the year for certain things. March 1st is the last day for property taxpayers to file an appeal on their property assessments for the town assessor's office or the Board of Selectmen. April 15th is the last day for property owners to file for elderly, veterans, blind, solar, and other exemptions allowed by law. Please see the assessor's office for the proper forms that need to be completed and filed with your request. April 15th is the last day for charitable organizations to file their property inventory forms with the town. April 15th is the last day to file for current use property taxation exemption. April 15th is also the last day to file for the Hampton Beach Precinct tax exemption. For those who wish to file for any of these items just listed, please come to the assessor's office early, as there are forms needed to be filed with your request along with the necessary backup documents to verify your eligibility for the exemptions. And those things are important, otherwise you'll lose the exemption right. So, and that's it, Mr. Chairman.
Questions for the town manager?
Virginia. I'm all set. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I'd just like to reiterate to people that to pay attention to those dates on the appeals and the exemptions, that they're really important. So if you want to do any one of those, please check with the town and when the deadlines are. Make sure you meet them.
Call the assessor's office, please.
Call the assessor's office.
Bill? Do we just... The administrative order that has been
appealed. It is up on the town website. The appeal is on the town website, and I think in sort of echoing what the public works director said, and I believe I said this to the press earlier today. The reason everything that's stated in there is stated is because the law simply says that we must present every conceivable argument, good, bad, or indifferent, that can be used to undo the state order to the town. So in conjunction with the Public Works Department, in conjunction with the attorneys, we have filed a very comprehensive document outlining about every objection you can think of under the sun why their order shouldn't be dismissed. That does not mean, however, that in fact the appeal board will even accept the appeal, or if they do, that they'll grant the request for the appeal. That's something we don't know. We don't even know when in fact they will order it, either accept it or reject it.
but it was all filed within the time. So
it was filed on Friday, the 13th, which was today.
13th was today. So.
Is the last day to file. So we filed several days in advance. As soon as we filed, we had confirmation that it had been delivered to the state. We took the appeal and put it up on the town website so people could see it.
I know some people said this should be, the appeal should be decided before the Warren article. We have no control over that, do we?
We have no control over whether the state will even accept the appeal or will they decide it before the Warren article.
Right. So, I mean, it would be nice, but we have no way of controlling that.
No, we don't. Wish we did, but
yeah.
Okay. Rick Canning. Okay. Old business. Anything on the old business?
I just want to ask, because just to be, make it clear again, they just asked, what about the recycling?
Jim, you want to step down?
He stepped back.
What is the policy, just the policy as we know it?
It's no different for recycling or trash. We don't collect recycling from condominium projects where trash is not collected.
Mm-hmm. And again, it's the time in carts and picking them up, and the people it takes 2 minutes roughly to pick up each cart, and they're already at their maximum right now.
It's not because they're condos; it's just because right.
And when condos have the make their arrangements to have their trash picked up with the private haulers or whatever, that's usually when they make a decision on how they're going to have the recycling picked up.
They can do that one of two ways. They can obviously have the company they hire pick it up separately, and there are some condominiums in town, I understand, that in fact do that. Or, as individuals, they can bring their recycling to the transfer station.
Yes. So that's a good answer.
Because they are residents. But they can bring their trash to the transfer station, we just can't pick it up.
Right.
Thank you.
New business. Anything on the new business?
Paper.
Closing comments.
Yep.
Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Hi, Rick. 2026.